What is my go-to de-stressor? Well, I think it is talking to people. So I've been fortunate to be part of the Stanford Seed Transformation Program that has given me a network of friends, of people who are in a similar journey as I am in. And sometimes you look at someone who's probably a lot larger than you in revenue and team size, and we call them to discuss our problems, and then we hear that they also are facing similar issues. It just makes us feel that, hey, you know, I thought when I grow to be 10x, I will actually solve those problems. But, you know, when I'm hearing that, I realize that these are all problems that are, the challenges that one faces with entrepreneurship. So that kind of de-stresses me. So I have a speed list of a bunch of people that I usually reach out to and talk. So I think that's really what I would, do to de-stress myself. Is enough importance being given to mental health? I think probably not, especially as an entrepreneur. I think, you know, the whole trials and tribulations of entrepreneurship, right? The challenges that come from making those general management decisions that you need to make. You need to just take a punt on yourself, right? Your decisions. And sometimes those decisions go wrong, and, it just builds up stress. We start questioning our ability, our leadership, our, whether we will be able to get to our goals or not. And this pressure is added because, you know, in front of the team, you have to still act like you got it figured out when you are yourself figuring it out, right? So I think this is something that should be discussed. I think that there should be more avenues, there should be more conversations among startup founders on this issue. In fact, we are seeing that in Silicon Valley. I think even in Bangalore, this is an endemic problem. I think we should have more forums to talk about it. My message to fellow founders on mental health would be figure out what works for you, right? Just understand that you are not alone in this journey. I think everybody is going through a similar journey. We all have our coping mechanisms. So make sure that you are able to figure out what is your coping mechanism that is going to help you through the turbulent times.